All right, Carly.
63.
Do you agree or disagree with Carly? I see most people agree. I'm looking for a difference of opinion. Abby, you have a difference of opinion. 64. Okay, let's look. Let's count. 10. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 61,
62, 63.
So it was 63. So in the number 63, how many 10s do we have? Emily.
6.
And how many 1s do we have? Paige.
3.
Very good. All right, so now we are rounding to the nearest 10. So if you tell me what this rounds to, I also want to know your strategy. How did you know? Maggie.
I knew it, I got the answer 10 because 3 is 4 or less. So I kept the 1 the same and everything after becomes a 0. So that's how I got it.
Perfect. So Maggie thinks 10. What do you guys think? Okay, I see everyone is agreeing, so we'll go to the next one. 29. Cash.
I think it's 30 because 9 is above 5, so I counted up and I got 30.
All right, let's see. Everyone agrees. 65.
Phew.
You're clearing up.
Check. 70 because it's 5 or more, so it's like a roller coaster, so it's not going backwards, it's going down.
Very good, because it's at the peak with the 5. Nice explanation, and I see we are agreeing. 99. Let's think about this. Mia, what do you think?
It's 100 because 9 is above 5, so it's going down to the
lowest. It's 100. What do we think? Okay, all in agreement. Okay, so now we're at, there's one more, sorry. 147. What do you think, Blake?
I think it'll be 150 because 7 is 5 or more, so
I would add more. So, what do we think about 150? You're right, Jeremiah. They did say the nearest 10, so he was rounding to the 10s. 140. So, can someone explain why it was 150 and not 140? I like that you're noticing that we do have to round to the 10s. So, Brock.
I think
you forgot? Okay. Jacob.
Well, it is 150 because 7 is higher than 5, so 7 would be closer to 50.
So what they're saying is, because they are going to the nearest 10, if we were on that number line we practiced, it would be between, what are my two benchmark numbers then? What is this number in between? Kyle?
140
and 150. So what would it be closest to if there's a 7? 150. Does that make more sense? Okay. All right. We're at number talk. So 39 plus 16. So remember, when you come for the strategy, you don't want to rush anyone, so put your thumb in front of you. So I know you have a way to solve it. I should see everyone looking until they have their thumb up. All right, Abby. Can you explain what you would think? Okay, so you tried to stack them, so you looked at place value, and you got 56? All right, let me see what you guys think. 56, let's see. All right, I see some people disagreeing. Would anyone that is respectfully disagreeing like to share why they... Jana... Mm-hmm. questions and you got the answer 55. Did anyone use a strategy besides algorithm? Because when we're stacking, we're using the algorithm. Mental math, we want to use some of those different strategies we talked about. Cash.
I used the base 10.
Okay, can you explain?
So I got 3 tens and 9 ones, and I added the 1 ten, and I added six ones, and I had and I had 10 for the ones place, so I added another 10 stick to the
and you got 55. Okay, let's look at a different one. 28 plus 39. So what is the sum here? Oh, I love that Gavin, I can see he's thinking and he has his thumb up. He's ready to share one strategy. Quentin.
I saw that we have 9 and 8.
Okay.
So, I let the 8 give the 1 to the 9, made them a 10, gave it to the 2, and the 8 is now a 7, and I saw now we have 67.
Okay, so you kind of did like, you made it a friendly 40, and then you have 27 plus 40? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I made it friendly and equal. The tens were now equal.
Ah, so it's easier to add. Do we agree or disagree with... So what was your sum?
My sum was 67.
Okay. Anyone use a different strategy? Nick.
I just made 39 and 40 and just counted up by one.
Okay, and you also got 67? All right, very good. Next one. 59 plus 13. All right, Gavin.
It's 78.
How? How'd you get it?
Because I made 59 and 60,
and I 12. Keep going. I think you're revising your thinking right now.
I made the 59 a 60, and the 50 was a 12.
So 60 plus 12. Let him explain his thinking.
72.
What do you think about 72 for the sum? Trent, I see you're disagreeing. What do you think?
I think it's 82.
Okay, can you explain?
Because when you add the 10 to the 50, it makes 60. When you add the 9 to the 3, it makes another 10, so 70, and then you have 2 left over 1, so 72.
So you did get 72. Yeah. So you actually are agreeing with Gavin. All right, so 72. Let's try the next one. 23 plus 49. 23 plus 49. Looking for some thumbs up, so I know we have a strategy. Carly.
I think it answers 72 again.
Tell me about it. Explain.
I did 9 plus 3, and then I got 12. And then I carried the 1 to my 4, and then I made it a 5, and then I added 2.
Okay. What do you think of Carly's answer of 72? Did anyone use, I see a lot of agreeing, but did anyone use a different strategy? Natalia?
I did. Yeah.
You stacked it too? So I think that's what she was saying when she was using her regrouping. Nick?
I did 20 plus 40, and I got 60. And then I did 9 plus 3, and I got 12, and I did 12 plus 6.